is going at the back, what are you doing? Right foot, you turn it, pull me on.
In the beginning?
Yeah.
I come up here.
Mm-hmm. Yeah?
Here. Because I turn to the left, I go forward with my knee, I come up with my toes, my heel. Heel. I come up with my heel, I come up with my heel, go forward with my knee, I turn with my left, and I come up with my toes. Yeah? Here. Glenn Smith, in the beginning, he was standing like this. So it's more, if you stay with a foot like this, it's more difficult to come over the left. You have to stay in a comfortable position here, comfortable, relax, and again. You can do it 50 times, 100 times. I got blisters on my toes. Yeah? Okay, that's the way how I do it. Between my throws. For example, I do my standing throws. Usually I do 10. Around 10, 12 standing throws. And when I feel, okay, first time I'm throwing with a spin, I do a few drills or a few imitations. Yeah? And then I throw, and then I feel it's not very good how I throw, then I do some imitation, some more imitation, and I pick up the discus and throw imitation again, always between how I feel. Yeah? Yeah, then if everything is going automatically and of course, in Birmingham, for example, my first throw was too low.
Yeah.
So I didn't think about to throw higher.
Yeah.
But now I see the pictures. I have to think about go lower down here.
Yeah.
Go lower, come lower here. Stay in this position the whole turn. Until the power position, and then you can come up. Yeah. So, Savory, he is doing like this, and then he comes up, and he goes up around like this. Yeah. So, go down, stay down here, stay down until the power position. And then throw. Competition, a foul is a foul. So, but for me, it takes much energy always to think about not to foul. Yeah. So, I had to think about my important points in the throw, and finally, in the end, the most important point is the block, the left foot. And then the final throw. So, I did think about this throw, this point, and I did throw and throw and throw, and then I did a few throws where I do my reverse, and like competition throws, and stay in the circle. The problem is when you throw fouling at the training, the problem is from this direction. You turn around and you throw and go out. Yeah. So normally you don't have you don't have the right power position. Yeah? So the problem is you turn around and you are very far and going forward. When you throw no foul, then you have to go more to the power position. More down in the power position, and automatically you have to come more up here, and it's much more easy not to foul. Yeah? But you have, from the power position, you have to come up here, and then you stay very stable. Yeah? If you are already up here, like savory, then you have just an arm throw, yeah, and the upper body is far already in the front, so you just throw here and easy the foul, yeah. It's to understand. Everybody didn't understand? Was it enough? Then we sit down and talk about training. Yeah? Okay?
Tell a little bit about the system. The problem is, here in the West, you have too much liberty. You can do what you want. In the East, they have a very hard system. It's also a problem. It's very strict, or it was very strict. Now everything is changing. We have to see how the future looks like. We will see it. And can I sit? Is this okay? Yeah? So in the East, everything is planned. Is planned, is this right? Every day is planned, every week is planned, every month is planned, the whole year is planned. It's not enough. They plan whole 4 years. They plan in cycles until the Olympic Games, and then they plan another 4 year cycle. So, in the West, so much liberty, everybody is doing his own thing, and very little system, few coaches, very few full-time athletes. In the East, many full-time athletes. So, now you have to see what you can do with your time, how is your job, how often in a week you can train, and so you have to see the best what you can do. Yeah. So I think the most important thing is to train every day. For me it was more easy very early. I he will jump 7 meter 48 or 58. This is VR and long jump. So he was a great athlete, and I'm lucky to have such a father. So back to the reality, how it is. It's important to train every day. Of course, you need rest. And for example, you have to work 8 hours, and you train in the evening 2 hours, and you are very tired and are having not enough time to do all the other things. Yeah. So, but you have to try to give your best. Then you can train maybe just 1.5 hour or 1 hour. But at least I think you have to train for 1 hour. And then you have to train very intensive, yeah, and very economic. So, important is also to have a rest day. It's also important. For me, always Sunday, I did no training. Depends on, for example, on Wednesday was a competition. So, I did maybe 1 week before. I had also a competition. So, I took rest on this 1 day before this competition. So I had already my rest day. The next day competition is not such a hard day. And then I did train. And then I did train on Saturday and train on Sunday. And on Monday twice, on Tuesday rest or just one training. And on Wednesday is a competition. So for you, it's normally the competition on the weekend. Yeah. This is done. So you have to prepare for the weekend. The weekend are having your rest. Otherwise, now in this cycle of training, I think it's also good to train on the weekend. Yeah. Because you have not another chance. On the weekend, Saturday and Sunday, you have free time. And if you really like to improve and to get number one in Britain, so you use the weekend for training, and maybe you take in a week where you work, you take a rest day. It's also possible. Yeah. You have to see how you feel. And my experience is, I am also lazy. Yeah. And my experience is, I had really lazy days. I didn't want to train, but I said I have to train. And I went to the track and start training. And after one round running and gymnastics and starting training, I felt it's getting better and better.